Hello, I'm Maria, and today I'm going to help you to stop those important emails from going to the spam folder. Did you know that up to 20% of emails will never make it to the recipient's inbox? Think about this. Out of 10 emails, on average, 2 will get lost. What if you were a business owner trying to communicate with your own customers? With email delivering on average return on investment of 122%, it's important to minimize the chance that your messages are in that 20%. So how do you do that? Today, we're going to explore 9 reasons why your email is going to that blasted spam folder and provide you with tips on how to keep your messages out of spam. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. So, let's get started. The first and most obvious reason for your emails ending up in spam is because your recipients put them there. Even if your content is strong and the recipient expressly gave you permission to contact them, they may still decide to mark your email as spam as a way to clean up a cluttered inbox. They may also have forgotten why they subscribed to your list in the first place, or simply made a mistake. Unfortunately, if enough of your messages get flagged by users, it can cause spam filters to flag your address and start sending your mail to spam automatically. This means your messages may end up looking like spam, even to users who have not explicitly flagged you in the past. This is especially likely in Gmail, Outlook, Yahoo, and other services with heavily AI-driven algorithms. Once the email ships, there's not much you can do to prevent someone from marking your emails as spam. What you can do is make sure your content is top-notch and that you follow other best practices to avoid having your email perceived as spam by users. This can minimize the chance that someone will intentionally flag your communications. We'll cover some of these strategies in the following sections. While text-only emails are fairly straightforward, they might not be a viable option for some businesses like e-commerce stores, as they may lead to lower engagement when compared to emails that include branding, images, and other HTML elements. However, when including HTML in your messages, it's important to follow some simple rules to ensure that they don't end up in spam folders. Here are some HTML best practices for email according to MailChimp. Keep the maximum width of your email between 600 and 800 pixels. Assume that any images will be blocked by email clients and that users may not see critical information if it's contained within media elements. Keep your code as clean and light as possible, particularly CSS. In addition, avoid JavaScript and Flash entirely. Make sure your messages are mobile-friendly. In fact, it's generally a good idea to design everything with a mobile-first philosophy these days. When it comes to fonts, you'll also want to make sure the ones you choose are cross-platform and clearly legible. Arial, Verdana, and Georgia are all solid options. Finally, it's a good idea to make most of your email's content text and minimize the amount of HTML you include. Your company branding and maybe a pop of color can do wonders for engagement without going overboard. Subject lines are typically the first impression a user gets of your message, so they need to grab attention and entice the reader to open the email. However, they also need to be honest. A misleading subject line isn't just poor etiquette. It's also against the law, according to the CAN-SPAM Act. Over half of email respondents report feeling cheated or tricked into opening an email based on the subject line, according to Litmus. That's a quick way to get your email tossed in the spam folder, and it may even lead some users to unsubscribe. What does a misleading subject line look like? Here are some examples. Don't start your subject lines with RE unless you're actually replying to something. It's a blatant trick and a quick way to earn an unsubscribe. Similarly, using FW can make the person think they know you, the definition of misleading. Subjects like "Did I leave my phone at your place?" or "Did you hear about so-and-so?" may make users question whether they know the sender. Some subject lines aren't necessarily lies, but they are still a little too over the top. In general, you want to make sure that your subject line matches the content the reader will find in the email. Your subject lines should also be professional. That means no typing in all caps, and definitely no spelling or grammar errors. The free tool, Grammarly, can check your spelling, grammar, and punctuation automatically, and alert you of any issues that may alert spam filters. Now, you know what subject lines to avoid, but you still need to entice subscribers to open your messages. HubSpot has some excellent recommendations for creating strong headlines. Start with action verbs. Create a sense of urgency and importance. But again, don't be misleading. Pose an interesting or compelling question. Remember, whatever your subject line ends up being, make sure the content delivers on its promise. Otherwise, you risk damaging your reputation. This one is simple. Online privacy laws, like the GDPR, require that you must have express permission from recipients in order to send them emails. That means you can't simply purchase email lists to get quick access to a bunch of contacts. This isn't a good idea for other reasons as well, including poor targeting. However, it also means that even users who provide their email addresses on your site need to explicitly tell you that they want to receive emails from you, especially if they're a citizen of the EU. This can come in the form of a disclaimer during account creation or on your contact form. Or it could be a checkbox that users need to tick to indicate their willingness. While this isn't necessarily required in the US, it's still a good practice. People get a lot of emails these days, and if your messages start suddenly appearing in someone's inbox when they didn't ask for them, there's a decent chance they may be marked as spam. Spam filters check for certain words or combinations of words. If an email gets enough hits or contains those words in addition to some of the other items on the list, it can end up in spam folders. Spam trigger keywords can include free, lowest price, additional income, easy money, no cost, multiple exclamation points or dollar signs in a row, words with unnecessary spaces or punctuation, words that are in all caps. In general, there are words that are either heavily sales-oriented or clearly designed to get around spam filters, such as the extra spaces. While using a handful of these isn't necessarily a death sentence for your messages, using too many of them can be. Of course, some of these keywords are tough to avoid, especially if you're sending e-commerce or financial emails. To get around this problem, you can use varied language and try to get creative about how you phrase things. Above all, it's smart to avoid pushy or salesy language and make sure you're following proven best practices for writing email content we're highlighting here. Laws like CAN-SPAM in the US clearly state that your emails must include a clear way to unsubscribe. Additionally, if someone does click on the unsubscribe link, you'll need to process that request within 10 days, and you can't force the user to jump through any hoops. While this might seem like a bad thing, why would you want to give people the chance to unsubscribe? It can actually have the opposite effect. Provided that your content is strong, giving people an easy way to get off your subscriber list shows that your brand is trustworthy. A major reason that your emails may end up in spam is incorrect from information. The from line, the one that tells your recipients who sent the email, needs to be accurate and not misleading. In some cases, a tool on your site, such as a contact form plugin, might be sending spoof emails with from details that trigger spam alerts. You want to make sure that the from field in your contact form settings has the admin address for your site, rather than the email address entered into the form. If you're having the contact form send you email notifications, also make sure the addresses used in from and to are different. Another common reason that your email's from information may be wrong is when email authentication isn't properly set up through a service like MailChimp or one of its alternatives. Authentication authorizes the service to send emails on your behalf, so they'll appear with your domain name attached even though they were sent by a third party. If your authentication isn't set up properly, your emails can end up going directly to the recipient's spam boxes. There are a few different types of email authentication out there, with the main ones being Domain Key Identified Mail, DKIM, Sender Policy Framework, SPF, and DMARC. DKIM provides an encryption key and digital signature to verify an email, while SPF works by verifying the IP address of the sender against a list of approved IPs. DMARC is a bit different, in that it requires the other two to be enabled unless the sender indicate that their emails are protected by DKIM or SPF. If you use an automated email service and you're having problems with delivery, authentication is a good first thing to check. Attachments are a huge red flag for spam filters. This is because files can be easy vectors for malware and viruses. The general rule of thumb is to simply not send any attachments at all, especially in newsletters. If you do need to send an attachment, make sure the recipient is aware ahead of time and minimize the number of files you attach to a single email. If you want to attach a document or file to an email, a safer bet is to first upload it to a cloud storage service like Google Drive or Dropbox. You can then include the link to the file in your email. That way, your message shouldn't trigger any spam filters. There are many reasons why your emails might end up in spam folders, from poor subject lines to keywords that trigger spam filters. Whatever the reason, it's important to resolve the issue to maximize your return on investment and maintain a trustworthy reputation among your audience. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.